Views on that video, so like thank you guys so much. Like it's a DIY video and it's just like I didn't expect that many people to like it, so I'm just like and we're like close to 2,000 subscribers and I'm just like I just can't thank you guys enough, but like I love it. Thank you guys so much. I love you and I promise to keep uploading more videos for you guys, more DIYs in the future, so stay tuned for that. But if you're new to my channel, hi, this is Rainer. I'm known as KPOPAMOO, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and I have another DIY video, so, but I think we should just, I don't know. Why am I so jittery? I don't know. But we should just get straight on into the video. And let's do it!
For the first DIY, you're going to be needing a wooden dowel. I got this at Michael's. In addition, you're going to need some twine. So with the twine, you're just going to be taking a piece that is longer than the wooden dowel and cut it out. And then you are just going to be tying both ends of the twine onto the dowel, such as this. And it will act as the hook. And this is how it should look like. Now taking three pieces of twine, which are about 34 centimeters long, you're going to loop them around the wooden dowel, which will act as string for the photos or Polaroids. Now with the pictures of your choice, you're just going to cut them out. I made these Polaroids on PicMonkey, if y'all are wondering, and these are so cute, like my biases, and like, look at them, like, ah-ha! Ew, what the heck? Anyways. Once you are done with that, you're just going to place them onto the photo string and see where they should go. Then after that, you are just going to flip the photos around and start taping them using tape. How they should look like in the end, and they look so cute, like oh my gosh, like I don't have actual Polaroids, but these will do, like Moving on to the next DIY, you're going to be needing a cork board. I got a pack of four at Michael's and that was really good. And I am literally using a clock as a circle to trace. And you're supposed to be tracing this around so that it creates a nice circle. Once you are done, you are going to be cutting it out. And yeah, this will act as the base for the clock that we are going to make. So yeah. Now taking a small circle or coin, you are just going to put it in the middle of the cork board and trace it, which will then act as a hole for the hands of the clock. Now taking the picture of your choice, which should be in the shape of a circle, or you can just print out numerous pictures, it doesn't really matter, but you are just going to figure out where it should go and go ahead and make a hole through the middle. So Now taking your Mod Podge, you're going to paste your picture or pictures onto the corkboard. I forgot to film the process of me pasting it onto the board, but I have this footage of me just using Mod Podge to ensure that it doesn't get damaged on the picture. Moving on, you will need a clock mechanism, which you can get through an old clock lying around. I got my mechanism on eBay for $2 for 3, so not bad. And in this part, you can see I am putting the hour hand first, and then second will be the minute hand, and then the last one will be the smallest, which is the seconds hand. So you're supposed to put that in that order, and it has to be parallel. Now taking your cork board, you're going to flip the front side over, and taking your E6000 glue or glue of choice, you are just going to glue the mechanism onto the back of it. Once you are done gluing it, you are just going to go ahead and put the hands back onto the mechanism, and you are done. Now this DIY is the easiest out of the three, but you are just going to need a photo board, which I got at Michael's on sale, and I'm just going to be taking off the clips. Now with a picture of your choice, I chose Sue Daddy because it's gay right now. You are just going to see where you want it and then cut it out, and then after that, you are just going to tape it back into the area where you want to put it, and that is all. And it's just really cute, and you can definitely just put Polaroids on here or favorite things, and yeah. Now the time that I've been waiting for, ratchet dance break, so enjoy! Eureka!
This new DIY video. I have more in store for you guys. Like, I don't know. DIY is just life. DIY. I mean, I will still do music video reactions, obviously, but you know, DIYs are just life right now. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this one, and please stay tuned for more. If you haven't already, please subscribe down below. I would love to have you as part of the family. Like I said, we're close to 2,000 subscribers, so I don't know. Ah! So that is the end of the video, guys, and please stay tuned for more. All right, bye.